Happy New Year's and welcome to our worship e-service this morning, friends. I'm glad that you've chosen to join us as we gather together as brothers and sisters in Christ as we come this the first Sunday of 2021. Welcome. If you're joining us for the first time, my name is Raymond. I'm a Methodist minister serving in the Makhale Circuit of the Methodist Church of Southern Africa. And I want to encourage you to participate in our service as you feel comfortable through this time of worship, as we connect with our brothers and our sisters in this time together. So friends, welcome. To get us going this morning, we're going to hand over to Luan and the music team as they lead us through our opening song, May Our Homes Be Filled With Dancing.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our e-worship service this morning. I'm going to invite you to sing our opening song with us, and that is May Our Homes Be Filled With Dancing.
Friends, as we continue to worship together this morning, there's just a few aspects of our service that I'd like to highlight for your attention. The first is that being the first Sunday of 2021, we're going to be celebrating Holy Communion together as part of our service today. So I want to encourage you to grab Holy Communion elements, grape juice and some wafer or bread or whatever you have with you in the space where you find yourselves at this time. We'll be having Holy Communion a bit later in our service. I'd also like to encourage you to grab a candle and something to light it with. As has become our custom through the time of national lockdown, we light a candle together as a symbol of the light of Christ being present where we are, in our homes, wherever we find ourselves at this moment and time as well. Because we remember, when we light this candle in the presence of Christ, becomes a sanctuary. We also light in unity with one another, in community with one another, as we connect through this virtual service with our brothers and sisters in Christ. So I'm going to encourage you to grab your lighter and your candle and something to light it with as we come to this moment as well. And as we light our candles, we're reminded that the light of Christ shines into the darkness of our world. The world has not understood this light. The darkness has tried to overcome it, but has never succeeded. And it's with that knowledge that we come this morning, to the knowledge that God is with us, that Christ Emmanuel is with us today in the places and moments in which we find ourselves at this time. With that in mind, we come to a time of opening prayer. Let's pray. Almighty and ever-loving God, as we come to you today, we thank you that you are with us, that your Spirit surrounds us, that your presence and your light shine into the moments and situations in which we find ourselves at this time, Almighty God. And we thank you for your presence, for your light, for your presence being there in the moments of despair and of hopelessness at this time. Friends, I want to give you a moment just to lift up your prayers, inviting God's light and God's presence into the space, the place in which you find yourselves as we begin this new year with God. Just lift up and invite him into those places. O Christ, we invite you into our space. Walk with us. Bring your sense, your presence, your light into the moments and places we find ourselves. As we journey through this new year, Almighty God, we invite your light into every moment and every situation of the year that lies ahead. Strengthen us to embrace it and to journey with you. For we ask this in your name, Jesus. And Father, with this knowledge in mind that you are so close, that you are with us, we often are mindful of our sinfulness in the areas that we fall short in our lives through the things we have done, through the things we have said, through the things we have even thought that have damaged our relationship with you and with others. So friends, in the quiet of this prayer, I want to invite you to lift up your prayer of confession as you lift up your sins to God now. Lift up your prayers, friends. As we lift up these, our prayers to your mighty God, we thank you that you hear them and that you are active in forgiving, that you have made a way, Almighty God, through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, to come back into relationship with you, with Jesus having paid the price and made it our way available. We give you thanks that we receive your love and your grace afresh, Almighty God, but most of all, the knowledge that we are forgiven as we've confessed these our sins. As we hear the words, your sins are forgiven, go and sin no more. We ask, Almighty God, through your Holy Spirit's empowering, that you would continue to heal us in the innermost parts of who we are, to turn away from these areas of sin in our lives and back to you, Almighty God. Strengthen us as only you can, for we ask this in your precious name, Jesus. And we pray together as in unity with one another, the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Friends, the peace of the Lord be with you. And I hear you saying, and also with you, Raymond. So friends, I want to invite you in whatever platform you're able, maybe on the video description of this video or on our WhatsApp chat groups, to simply give a shout out, the peace of the Lord being with you. So friends, the peace of the Lord be with you in this time. And as we continue to worship in this space as brothers and sisters in Christ, we come and we sing together, Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone. Luan, music team, over to you guys.
Our second song for this morning is Amazing Grace, My Chains Are Gone. I'm going to invite you to sing this one with us.
Notices today are found within the video description of this video. They've also been made available through our WhatsApp info groups, and I'd like to encourage you to take a moment to read through them so that you're aware of what's taking place in our communities of faith at this abnormal time. There are two I'd like to highlight for your attention. The first being the temporary suspension of all in-person worship services in the Mahale circuit of the Methodist Church of Southern Africa. As per the government directions, all churches are not to have services for 14 days, ending on the 15th of January. With that in mind, we will not be having any in-person worship services in order to curb the spread of COVID-19, in order to try and flatten the current spike rate, and as a sign of love for one another. Now, we will not be having any in-person worship services, but we will be having online e-services available every Sunday. That's this Sunday, the 3rd of January, the 10th of January, and also from there forward as an alternative to when we go back to in-person worship as well, hopefully on the 17th of January. That decision will be communicated once the circuit management have met and evaluated where we find ourselves, both with government direction as well as the safety of reopening our in-person worship sites for in-person worship. So please do keep an eye open for those notices as well. I'd like to encourage you during this time to lift up those who are working on the front line in prayer, as well as those in our communities who have become infected and affected by COVID-19 at this time. The second notice is our Faith for Daily Living booklets. Please note that we will not be receiving any printed Faith for Daily booklets for January, February due to the COVID-19 pandemic. With that in mind, I have made the link available in the video description for you to download a copy of the digital copy for your personal use as well. I have also made that digital copy available on our WhatsApp info groups, and I'd like to encourage you to use it as a daily devotion to feed your faith during this time as well. Just a reminder, we also have our daily reflections that go out, and I'd like to encourage you to use those as a way of feeding your faith during this time as well. So that's the notices for now, friends. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank those who continue to give so generously into the life of our community of faith as a son. Thank you. As the church receives your giving, as you give to God of your tithes and offerings, we use it for the sustaining of our church sites, to meet the overhead costs of running our church sites, as well as our online services as well. So friends, a big thank you to those who continue to give. If you're joining us today and you're from another faith community, I'd like to encourage you to give into your faith community, as we're encouraging our members to give into our communities of faith at this time as well. If you're struggling to give, please do reach out to me or one of the society stewards of the society in which you find yourselves, and we'll gladly assist you in giving of your tithes and offerings into the life of our church at this time. With that said, let's come to a time of prayer as we commit the business of our church and our giving to God. Let's pray. Almighty and ever-loving God, we give to you with grateful and cheerful hearts of what you have given us, that which is given through various forms into life of your church. Receive it, Father, as we give our tithes, our offerings, out of love for you. Receive it for the furtherment of your kingdom, that the gospel of Jesus Christ may be preached for healing and for transformation, particularly in this difficult time of COVID-19 and national lockdown in which we find ourselves. Strengthen us, Almighty God, as we seek to be your community of faith, as we seek to grow in relationship with you and one another. Guide us to be wise in the ways in which we do it. Give those who lead your churches guidance in how they use the gifts that are given, but also wisdom in the ways forward during this abnormal and difficult time. Guide us, we pray, for we ask this all in your precious name, Jesus, now and always. Amen. Friends, as we continue to worship this morning, we come and we sing together the splendor of the King. Here I am to worship. Luan, music team, over to you guys.
Oh, can I just be?
We continue to worship God this morning, friends, as we come in a time of intercessory prayer. Now, I believe in this moment in which we find ourselves under this resurgence of the spike and the resurge in infection rates that we are seeing taking place at this moment in time, we need to come to God in prayer. Obviously, lifting up this time in which we find ourselves and our prayers to God, perhaps those who we know who aren't well and who are affected and infected with COVID-19 and the new variant thereof as well, those who work on the front lines of this fight against COVID-19, essential workers, and those who are struggling at this time. With that in mind, let's come to a time of prayer. Almighty God, we come to you during this time of prayer, and we lift up our prayers of intercession. As we lift up those who at this time are struggling, Almighty God, with this COVID-19 and the pandemic, we are struggling, Almighty God. Friends, I want to invite you to lift up in this time of quiet your prayers for friends, for family who are struggling with COVID-19 and what that may look like for them at this time. Lift up your prayers. Thank you that you hear these our prayers, Almighty God. We lift up those who are on the front line of the fight against COVID-19. We think of those in the medical field, both nurses, doctors, and those who work in the medical professions. We pray, Father, that you would be with them in this time of spike, where they are overworked and overwhelmed, that you'd be with them and their families, as many have become ill themselves, Almighty God. Friends, perhaps you know those who are working on the front lines, nurses, doctors, cleaners, pathologists, those who are in the front line of the fight against COVID-19. Lift them up to God in this time of prayer. As we lift them up by name to your mighty God, we thank you that you are with them, that you renew their strength at this time, that you would remind them of your presence in the difficult situations and circumstances that they find, the constant grief and loss that they're encountering at this time. Bless them as only you can, Almighty God. We think of families who have lost loved ones, who are grieving at this moment in time. Friends, lift them up. Perhaps you know a family or a friend who has passed on, who has been affected by the death of a loved one. Lift them up to God in this time, we pray. We pray your comfort upon them, Almighty God, your presence, your peace in this time of grief and loss, that you would surround them, Almighty God, with a deep sense of your comfort. Those who are struggling to, Father, for their lives on ventilators, those who are self-isolating in their homes or in hospital, we lift them up to you now as well, Almighty God. And perhaps you know people who are in those situations, friend, and I invite you to lift them up to God in this time of prayer. We thank you that you hear these our prayers, Almighty God. We pray for those who have been economically and other ways impacted by the national lockdown due to COVID-19 and the pandemic we find ourselves in. We pray that, Father, you would reach into those spaces and that you would be with them in this moment, providing for their needs, guiding and comforting them in this time as well as we begin a new year. We ask new opportunities. New opportunities for employment and income, Almighty God. We pray, Father, that you would be with them guiding and directing, opening the doors that need to be opened and closing those that need to be closed. So, Father, we thank you that you hear all of these our prayers, for we ask them now in your precious name, Jesus, now and always. Amen. Friends, as we come to the Word of God today, our reading is from Matthew 2, verses 1 to 12. I'm going to be reading from the New International Version of the Bible, but I want to encourage you, if you have a Bible nearby, to grab your Bible and to follow with me as we read together from Matthew 2, verses 1 to 12. So now the words are on the screen, and I'm going to be reading from Matthew 2, verses 1 to 12 from the International Version of the Holy Bible, which reads as follows. After Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, during the time of King Herod, Magi from the east came to Jerusalem and asked, "Where is the one who has been born King of the Jews? We saw his star when it rose and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was disturbed, and all Jerusalem with him. When he had called together all the people's chief priests and teachers of the law, he asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In Bethlehem in Judea," they replied, "for this is what the prophet has written. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means the least among the rulers of Judah. For out of you will come a ruler who will shepherd my people Israel." Then Herod called the Magi secretly and found out from them the exact time the star had appeared. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search carefully for the child. As soon as you find him, report to me, so that I too may go and worship him." After they had heard the king, they went on their way, and the star they had seen when it rose went ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star, they were overjoyed. On coming to the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and they bowed down and worshipped him. Then they opened their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to go back to Herod, they returned to their country by another route. Friends, this is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Father, as we come to your holy scriptures today, we ask that you'd open our eyes, our hearts, and our minds, that you, Father, would speak your word into us, that we may understand what it is you're saying to us and make it part of who we are. So may the words of my mouth and meditation of each and every one of our hearts be pleasing to you, our rock and our redeemer, Jesus Christ, our Lord, now and always. Amen. Friends, for many people, tomorrow is the beginning of a new working year. Now, I'm not forgetting those who go back to work or open their companies on the 11th of January, or perhaps have already gone back to work, and those who work through the festive season and need to still go on holiday. But as most people go back to work tomorrow, it marks the end of the festive holiday season and the going back of life to some form of new normal in this time of national lockdown and the pandemic, with our school children and teachers only going back to school hopefully on the 25th of January. With this in mind, friends, I'd like to take the opportunity today to briefly explore the question, what do we do with Christmas? Now, most people by now have either packed away their Christmas tree and the decorations, or are waiting for the 6th of January, the day of Epiphany, or known by some as Three Kings Day, to do so. This coming week, we'll be remembering Epiphany Day on the 6th of January, which marks the end of the church season of Christmas and the day on which traditionally Christmas decorations are packed away. My concern, however, is that as most people pack away their Christmas trappings and decorations, do they also pack away Christmas and their encounter with the Christ child until Christmas time comes again at the end of 2021? So as we remember that change in time, both from holiday to that of going back to work, but also in the church calendar from Christmas to Epiphany, we move into a season of revelation and discovery about who this Christ child really is. In our reading from the Gospel of Matthew, we encounter the story of the Magi, or the wise men. And it's in this account of the visit of the Magi we see three very important aspects of their visit, an encounter of baby Jesus, Emmanuel, that speak to us today. These being, Firstly, the wise men came. Secondly, the wise men worshipped. And lastly, the wise men returned home. You got it? The wise men came, the wise men worshipped, the wise men returned home. Well, let's dive in. The wise men came. In our reading, we are told, in the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea, wise men came from the east to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? We observed his star and its rising and have come to pay him homage." Friends, we know that these wise men were learned people, astrologers, who had probably studied through the Old Testament and knew that there would be a Christ who would be born the Messiah, the King of the Jews. In Numbers 24:17, we read about a star that will rise to announce his arrival. And as the wise men and the Magi came, they came asking, "Where is the baby born to be King of the Jews? We saw his star when it came up in the east and have come to worship him." Friends, they saw the promised star and came with hope of worshiping, of paying homage, giving respect to the Christ child, the Messiah. We're told in our reading that these wise men traveled from the east. Now, we're not entirely sure where in the east. Were they from Arabia or India or China or some eastern region? But tradition says and gives the most believable explanation when it says that they came from Perthia, a region near ancient Babylon. Now, this is a very plausible suggestion if we remember that almost 800 years before this event, the people of Israel were conquered by the Babylonian Empire. In other words, the world superpower of that day, and were taken into exile in Babylon. Now, Babylon was a long way from Jerusalem and Bethlehem. To be exact, it was about 1,500 kilometers away. Now, that's a long way to go, following and hoping to find baby Jesus. We're told in our reading that the three wise men came bringing gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Very precious and expensive gifts fit for a king. So friends, they prepared to come. From this we see that the wise men prepared and came with great personal expense, despite the distance and conditions, they came. Secondly, we learn that the wise men worshipped. Our reading goes on and tells us, when they saw the star that had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. They entered the house. They saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Friends, the wise men arrived and worshipped baby Jesus. They came and paid homage and gave their gifts, gifts worthy of a king. But they also represent a larger meaning behind their presence. They represent the entire world. They worship symbolically as the world coming to Jesus, a manifestation of Christ to the nations, light of Christ to all people, to all nations, a Messiah for all people. So the wise men prepared, the wise men worshipped, and the wise men returned home. Our reading tells us, "And after having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. When all was done, they returned home, but by another path, after having themselves encountered divine message, to return via another route home and not to return to Herod. They returned changed people, people who had encountered Emmanuel, God with us." But what does this mean for us today? Friends, we too prepared and eagerly awaited the coming of Christmas Day. With Christmas shopping and other preparations, perhaps our concerns and our fears, maybe our questioning how we will celebrate Christmas in a time of lockdown and pandemic, as we prepare to face a different Christmas this year, a COVID Christmas from last year. We journeyed through a season of Advent, preparing ourselves spiritually for the coming of Emmanuel in the form of baby Jesus, so that we too could come and seek the baby born to be King of the Jews, Messiah of all people. We, like most of the world, came and we worshipped. Some just worship the gifts that they received, but others embrace the Christ child. And we're re-encountering Emmanuel, that the light of God had come into the world, that God is with us. We too now face the reality of returning home, returning to the ordinary things of life. But have we changed or been challenged by the encountering of the Christ child, the light of the world, Messiah, Emmanuel? Or have we simply gone through the motions yet again, but in another year? So the question is, friends, what do we do with Christmas? Now, this is a truly, deeply personal question, which only you know the answer to, and one which I'd like you to ask God and explore with God during your quiet time or time that you make to be with God this coming week. In other words, ask God to show you what to do with your encounter with Christmas and the Christ child, with God with us, Emmanuel. Because as we enter this new year of 2020, I'd like to encourage you to continue to embrace Emmanuel, to know that God is with you, despite the circumstances you may experience this coming year, both good and bad. I'd like to encourage you to seek afresh to know and discover more about this baby Jesus, born King of the Jews, Savior of all, and to take with you into the world the knowledge and message that Jesus was born, ministered, died, and rose again for all people, paying the price for our sins, for all people's sins, for Jews and Gentiles, for the wealthy and the poor, the oppressed and the oppressor, male and female, young and old, for all people. Let us encourage the world to seek Christ as the Magi did. Maybe you'll be the only star leading them to Jesus. Let us pray. Almighty and ever-loving God, we thank you for your word of Holy Scripture to us today. As we hear of the Magi coming, having prepared themselves and having journeyed, having prepared for the cost of that journey of Christmas, to come and experience the Christ child, encounter and worship the Christ child. And as they worship, Father, giving their gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh, and then returning home. Father, that you would be with us as we too have journeyed this journey of preparing ourselves through the season of Advent to encounter the Christ child afresh, of coming to you, Emmanuel, God with us, and having worshipped, having given gifts out of love for others as symbols of giving gifts to you. As we worship you with all of who we are, we ask, guide and direct us, Almighty God. As we return from this space of worship to some places of ordinary, a new normal in which we find ourselves at this abnormal time, we go back with the knowledge that you are with us, that you are with us in every moment and situation in which we find ourselves. So let us embrace that afresh, the knowledge that you are with us. Help us, we pray. Strengthen us, we pray. For we ask this in your precious name, Jesus. Help us to know what to do with what we've heard this morning. For we ask this in your name, Jesus, now and always. Amen. Friends, as we come and respond to the word of God today, we sing our last Christmas carol of the season of Christmas as we sing together, We Three Kings of Orient Are. And I want to encourage you to praise God as we read and sing these words together in this time. Luan Music Team, over to you guys.
Oh,
Friends, as we continue to worship God today, we come to a time of Holy Communion. This being the first Sunday of the month and the first Sunday of 2021, we come and we celebrate the sacrament of Holy Communion together. Just a reminder that as we process through the service, you're going to need a wafer, a biscuit, or a bread of some sort that we can break as the body of Christ, and some grape juice or water or something that you can celebrate with us in this moment as well, the blood of Christ. I'm going to put a liturgy on the screen. I'm going to ask that we go through it. And I'm going to ask that you assist me with the parts that are underlined. The Lord be with you and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. It is indeed right. It is our duty and our joy. Gracious and holy Father, always and everywhere to give you thanks. In the beginning, your Spirit swept across the face of the waters, bringing order and beauty out of chaos. You formed us in your own image and breathed into us the breath of life. Though we turned away from you, your love remained steadfast, and you sent your only Son, Jesus Christ, to be the Saviour of the world. At his baptism in the Jordan, he was anointed by your Spirit and revealed as your beloved Son. In the power of the Spirit, he was sent to preach good news to the poor, to proclaim release to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty those who were oppressed, and to announce that the time had come when you would save your people. Sharing in our human nature, he died on the cross. Raised again in glory, he lives forever to pray for us. By the gift of the Spirit, whom you have sent in his name, you bring to completion the work of your Son, leading us into all truth, making us a people for your praise, and giving us power to proclaim the gospel in all the world. And so, with the faithful of every time and place, we join with choirs of angels in the eternal hymn, and we say together, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth be full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. On the night before he died, the Lord Jesus took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup of wine. He gave thanks and gave it to them, saying, Drink from it, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me. And so we, in remembrance of all his mighty acts, we offer you these gifts, and with them ourselves as a holy living sacrifice. And we say together, You send forth your Spirit. You bind us in love. You renew the face of the earth. Pour out your Holy Spirit, that these gifts of bread and wine may be for us the body and blood of Christ. Unite us with him and with one another in mission to all the world, and bring us with your whole creation to your heavenly kingdom. We say together, through Christ, with Christ, in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. And I'll invite you, friends, in this moment to take your bread and just to break it. Though we are many, and we say together, sorry, though we are many, we are one body because we all share one bread. Friends, receive this holy sacrament of the body and blood of Christ and feed on the Lamb of God with reverence and with faith. The body of Christ keep you to eternal life. The blood of Christ keep you to eternal life. So friends, I want to invite you in this moment to take your bread, your wafer, whatever you have with you, and let us share together the body of Christ broken to us to preserve us to eternal life. To take a grape juice or water, whatever you have with you, and we share together the blood of Christ be with you, preserve you unto eternal life that I share together. I'm going to give you a moment to finish yours as we go back to the Holy Communion Liturgy. We pray together, God of power, may the boldness of your Spirit transform us. May the gentleness of your Spirit lead us. And may the gifts of your Spirit equip us to serve and worship you now and always. Amen. The Spirit of truth, lead us into all truth. Give us grace to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, and to proclaim the word and works of God. And the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit remain with us always. Amen. Friends, go into the world in the power of the Spirit to fulfill our high calling as servants of Christ. And we say together, thanks be to God. Amen. So friends, that brings us to the end of our time of Holy Communion. Be blessed. Friends, as we come to the end of our time together today, I want to encourage you to know that God is with you in the moments and the situations in which you find yourselves at this time. If you're in need of pastoral care, please do reach out. You've got my contact details, and I'll gladly assist you as I'm able during this time with pastoral care. Friends, I want to just encourage you to know that God is near. Be blessed, stay safe. And as we close our time together, we share with one another what's known as the benediction. We say together, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now and evermore. Amen. Friends, be blessed, stay safe, and know that God is with you, now and always. Amen.